I cannot believe that I tore a muscle working out, and because of that, I got a hematoma. It's crazy.
Keep giving me hope for a better day. Keep giving me
love. Good morning. Good morning. So I'm still kind of sick. I've been sick for like days. Today is the day that we are going. I am going to have my surgery to fix my seroma. Look at Benji, so cute over there in the corner. That's my bear, guys. So my surgery is at 1:45, which means I'm starving until then because I literally can't eat anything. So Jerome and Alex are in the kitchen having breakfast right now. I still have my prescriptions from my last surgery because it was only 6 months ago. So I have my prescription for nausea, muscle spasms, and literally just one for pain. And then I'll just have to refill my prescription for antibiotics, which unfortunately I didn't get ahead of time because I didn't have a pre-op appointment since I visited my surgeon about 2 months ago. Or whenever I uploaded that last video to figure out what was going on. She kind of already knows what's going on. So what's going to happen is I'm going to go in there. We have to be there at 12:30. They start prepping me at 12:45. And then the surgery should only take like 30 minutes. It starts at 1:45 because they have to get me to sleep. 30 minutes because she's only doing, you know, fixing this one boob. She should, from my understanding, is she's going to drain it. She's going to replace the implant altogether because that's just her professional preference. And then hopefully we'll just be on our way, living happily ever after. I'm really excited to get it over with because it's painful. It's just been so, such a nuisance, and I just want to get it over with and move on and never have surgery again. But anyway, so I'm not really as nervous as I was when I had my last surgery, of course, because I already know what to expect. And I guess that's pretty much it. I guess I don't feel nervous, but maybe when we get there and we get, you know, a little bit closer, I'll probably be nervous. I'm actually getting really hungry and super, super thirsty. And they told me I couldn't have any water past 8 a.m. and it's like 11 now. So that's that. I'm gonna get dressed, put some clothes on, and wish me luck. Also, I set this up for when we come home, so I know last time I used a lot of pillows, so I put this one for like back support and then for my head. And this one, the body pillow, is like a lifesaver. And of course, Benji, because Benji always makes me feel better. And I think I'm going to be, this is usually Jerome's side of the bed, but I'm actually sleeping over here because, well, so I don't, so when I sleep, I don't have to sleep on the side that my, I guess, hurt boob is on. So I've done this last night, but I just got out my like big Kate Spade bag because it's literally the biggest purse that I have. Okay, thanks. And I'm putting in like a pair of like easy to pull. You're so annoying.
Hey, where's my phone, babe?
I don't know, babe. Some like easy to pull on sweats. And then I have like a red button up. It buttons in the front shirt. And then I'm just gonna throw in all three of my prescriptions. I'm just wearing these like black shorts, and then this is the sports bra that they gave me when I had my first surgery, which comes undone in the front. So I'm wearing this, and I think that's it. Alex, how hot is it out here right now?
Too hot.
Too hot. Are you nervous, babe?
Not really.
Oh, okay.
Honestly, like, not really, but it's just annoying. Like, right now, I'm hecka chill.
We're early. It's only 12:23. We have at least 10 minutes before we need to go in there.
Of course we're early. You're always early.
I'm always early.
We don't have any service.
So we're here. It is 12:26, so we're a little bit early. Technically, we don't need to be here till 12:45, but I do need to go in a little early because I haven't paid yet, so I have to get that processed. I'm getting really nervous now. What do you know? Jerome's trying to fix my tripod because it broke. I just want to go in there and get it over with. I'm nervous. I was doing so good. Good morning, you guys. I didn't record yesterday after surgery just because I was in and out of sleep. So what actually happened was I still look horrible. what actually happened was my surgery was supposed to start at 1:45. It was the last surgery of the day, and because of that, for whatever reason, it got pushed back. So we were laying in the pre-op room, just checked in and waiting. Jerome was with me until, I don't even remember, but I want to say about 3 o'clock. At that time, they came in, they started my IV. 2 seconds later, so it was like an hour and a half late. And 2 seconds later, they rolled me into the actual room, or the surgery room. All I remember is moving, like halfway moving onto the bed, and then I feel like lights were just out. I wasn't even, they asked you to like scoot onto the next bed. I don't even remember getting all the way onto the bed. I remember I started pulling myself over to get onto the bed, and I don't remember anything after that. I always really, really hate going into the surgery rooms like awake. I just don't like looking around in there. It's cold and yeah, I don't know. But after surgery, I don't remember anything. It was really hard for me to wake up, and my nurse was kind of like rushing me out of there, which was kind of annoying, but I wasn't waking up, and finally I did. I got up and we left. We got in the car. I think we got home around 7 or 7:30, which is pretty late. Which is pretty late, and then Jerome had to go get my prescription for my antibiotics, and that actually only costed $8, so very cheap, and he went to go pick up Alex, and I was in and out of sleep all night yesterday, and then today, this morning, I think I woke up at like 2 a.m., and then 5 a.m., and then again at like 8 a.m., and I've just kind of been awake the whole time. My phone actually died. And I was just super bored, so I think tonight I'll make sure it's charged and I'm going to grab some headphones. Or maybe use the iPad or something, because I wake up at the most random times, and I was thinking I could be studying for my NASM certification. So if I'm just laying in bed and I am awake, then I think I'm going to use his iPad to do that. So yeah, that's it. It's about 10:30, almost 11 o'clock right now. We're going to leave around 11:30. Or 12 to go to my appointment. It's at 12:45. Jerome's actually making us some breakfast, and I'm gonna have a cup of coffee because last time I had surgery, I didn't have coffee for the days I was healing, and I started getting really, really bad migraines. If you watched my previous videos, you'll see that. And I really want to avoid that this time. So they told me make sure you're having some sort of caffeine because that's just what my body is used to. Right now, I'm just all wrapped up. Talking to you guys really takes the air out of me. I'm just all wrapped up. It's nice because my left side is totally fine. My arm is fine. My right side just hurts, but it's better than having both sides at once. So it is not as bad, but of course, you still have to be careful. So hard to like use your arm for anything. I was trying to put chapstick on, and I went to twist the lid back on, and it flexed my like pectoral muscle, and it really hurt. So just anything, can't use that muscle. They also sent me home with a drain. If you don't like blood, don't watch this next clip. But the drain, let's see, is right here. We just emptied it. It's like hooked inside of me, I guess. Well, obviously, I haven't seen it. I don't really know where.
But that's it. We're going to go to my checkup. Hope everything goes well. Actually, so sorry. I didn't even tell you guys. So, she actually found out, I don't think I've recorded this, that I had a hematoma, which is basically blood inside. So, it wasn't a seroma. It was actually a hematoma. There was old blood inside of my breast implant. I don't know if it's in the pocket, I guess. She cleared out all the old blood. She said it kind of gave her peace of mind because she's seen that there was a tear in my muscle, which must have been from the shoulder workout that I did. I forget which machine I was on, but it was like an incline shoulder press, military press of that sort. Can't think of it right now. My mind is like way out of it. But yeah, there was a tear in the muscle, and so she thinks that's where the blood came, and it was just sitting in there. It started getting even harder. I feel like it could have developed capsular contraction. I don't know if it did or not. I'll have to talk to her today, but that's it. She replaced the implant, took all the blood out, and she said, you know, she was happy to find that because she knows why, you know, my breasts, why that happened. And it was just a little amount of blood, but it obviously did a lot of damage. So happy to have that over with, and I'm really looking forward to talking to my surgeon today. So I will update you guys on anything she says, and that's pretty much it. Recovery is going well.
Alex, what are you doing?
Training for the filing. Oh,
yeah. Alex.
Yeah.
What are you doing? Okay, watch Harry Potter. We've decided to lay in bed and start watching Harry Potter in the very first movie.
We watch part one and part two.
And now we're on part two because Alex has never watched. It's so loud, babe. Because Alex has never watched Harry Potter before, so we really want to go to Harry Potter Land, so we figured now's the best time to get him in the loop. Good way to spend my recovery time. I'm super sleepy. Look at Alex's basketball hoop in the living room. How unnecessary. The chips are delicious. I'm disappointed that I went 22 years of my life and didn't know about them. They taste so good. I'm starving. Babe, no one wants fresh air.
Babe, I want fresh air. I feel stuck in here.
Spectropenophis!
Oh, perfect.
You have that on camera?
Yep.
Spectropenophis.
I hate that drum, like, sunlight and the window's open.
I like my drum. Eat.
I like for the house to be dark and closed.
Who cares? An excellent idea to show them that, Professor.
So I'm finally in bed now. I told myself that on these couple days while I was home that my arm really hurts to hold my camera. Ouch. I told myself that I would make sure to study at least two chapters in my NASM book. So I'm going to do that right now. I'm on chapter 9, and there's 16 chapters, and my test is on October 26th. So I really need to get that done. I think I have, like, what, 4 more weeks before 6? So I want to at least get 2 chapters done every week. So on my last week, I have time to just kind of study over things that I feel like I need to brush up on. So I'm going to do that right now. As we were laying on the couch right now, I was laying down flat, and it hurt really, really bad for me to get back up. So definitely will not be laying down flat anymore. I'll stay seated up, but I took a pain pill, and I'm just going to relax for a little bit and probably take a nap. So I guess on the bright side, one thing you can know is at least I had the hematoma, and we got it taken care of. Like, instantly, it's just gone. Let me show you guys. It's being pushed down by this band. But everything's, like, completely back to normal. A little flat because I have this band on. But
Everything's good. Completely back down. It was like way up here if you've seen in my other videos. So I guess if you ever go through this situation and you ever have a hematoma yourself or a seroma even, I thought that after I had surgery again, it was going to be like back to square one when my right side was like all up high and hard and I was going to have to go through another like 6 weeks where I couldn't wear an underwear or bra and all these things. Kind of just like the left side's perfectly set. It's kind of like I only had a breast augmentation on one side, if that makes sense. I thought like my right side was just going to be, I had to go through everything all over again, but you don't. You had surgery. My muscles already like shaped for my implant, the pocket was already there, everything was there, so she literally just basically took out the blood, replaced the implant, which she didn't even have to do, and that was it. So everything is completely back to normal. As far as recovery, it doesn't feel very bad at all. I mean, I want to be careful and just mindful that I obviously just had surgery because I'm one of those people who like to go and clean the house and do a thousand things, and then I'm like, oh crap, like my arm hurts, I shouldn't have done that. But everything's okay. I still have this drain in, which doesn't really have anything, and she's taking that out tomorrow morning at 9:45, super early. So I've still been taking painkillers because every time it wears off, the pain, it really just feels like I had an intense chest workout, which some people say their breast augmentation initially feels like that. It definitely didn't for me. It hurt like a motherfucker. It hurt really bad. But this one definitely feels more like an intense chest workout, and I just want to be careful. So recovery this time around, I feel like, is a breeze. It's going to be great. Everything's going good. I feel kind of like I can't wait to take a shower, but I'm going to wait because my incision is open. And, she told me that, can you go away? She told me that I could sponge bath tonight if I wanted to, or if I took a shower, just to be really careful. But I just decided like not showering for one day is not gonna kill me, so I'm gonna shower tomorrow.
Just for the record, this right here is a butterfly on my bra. It kind of looks like blood, and I just don't want you guys to be super grossed out, because it's totally not.
So it kind of sucks. So today is the third day in a row I've had to drive all the way to my surgeon's office, which really sucks because she lives in Palo Alto and I live in Fremont, which is not that far, but woo! The light is like in the shot, but it is a bridge right away. So I do have to cross the bridge. I've had to cross bridge for the last 3 days coming here. But whatever. Today, she's taking the drain out. Thank you, Jesus. I cannot believe that I tore a muscle working out, and because of that, I got a hematoma. It's crazy. So it's like that never happens. It never happens to anyone, and it happened to me. Like everyone, you know, you can get a breast augmentation. You're more than fine to work out, you're clear to work out, and it is bizarre that it happened to me, but it did. And so I'm just thankful that it's taken care of. I finally have the breast augmentation that I wanted.
Nothing's going right. Shadows took the